Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to another edition of the Android News Byte. Today, we're going to be talking about the launch of the next Snapdragon 7 chipset. Now, Qualcomm has a history of releasing three different versions of the same chipset. For example, last year, the company launched the Snapdragon 7 Gen 3 SoC. Then, in March, they announced a higher-end version of it, calling the chip the Snapdragon 7 Plus Gen 3. And now we have learned that there will be a Snapdragon 7S Gen 3 that will be officially announced in October of this year. First, let's look at the Snapdragon 7S Gen 3 specs. When it comes to its CPU cores, we are learning that it will be equipped with four Cortex A78 cores, which will all be clocked at 2.4 GHz. And it will also have four Cortex A55 cores, which will be clocked at 1.95 GHz. Then, on the graphics side, the Snapdragon 7S Gen 3 will use an Adreno 710 GPU, which looks to be clocked at 940 MHz. We've seen the Adreno 710 GPU used in the Snapdragon 6 Gen 1, although that chip runs those at a slightly lower clock speed. This chip will also support Bluetooth 5.4, 5G mobile connectivity, and even spatial audio. When it comes to performance, the Snapdragon 7S Gen 3 CPU cores will be 20% more powerful than its predecessor. The GPU performance is said to be 40% faster, and the NPU should be somewhere around 30% faster. With overall power efficiency is said to be 12% better than the previous generation. As we've seen a lot lately, AI looks to be a major focus with the Snapdragon 7S Gen 3. So we can expect to see faster and more efficient AI-related tasks, which many people will say that they don't care about, but it will help with more common tasks like photo editing as well. Other things to note with the Snapdragon 7S Gen 3 chipset is its support for AFME, aka Adreno Frame Motion Engine, which is Qualcomm's version of DLSS and AFMF. So it will be able to generate additional frames during gameplay without putting added stress on the GPU. That means we should be able to see 60 frames per second games go all the way up to 120 FPS with this technology. The chip also supports VRS Pro, aka Variable Rate Shading, which is a feature that increases rendering performance and quality by varying the shading rate for different regions of the frame. I'm expecting the Snapdragon 7S Gen 3 chipset from Qualcomm to make its way into a large number of mid-range smartphones and tablets over the next 12 to 24 months. And if history is anything to go by, these devices are likely to be priced quite competitively too. So let me know what you think down in the comment section below. We likely won't have performance benchmarks until later on this year, but the Snapdragon 7S Gen 3 SoC is one to keep an eye on. And before we end this video, please do not forget to tap that like button while also making sure that you're subscribed to the channel for more Android news content like this.